you're dealing with television, most people just they just grab the remote, they turn it on, and they see the picture, and they think, well, you know, it's just that easy. Well, it's not. And you actually have to spend hours, weeks, you know, to set up and get ready for an event, especially when you're dealing with, you know, DTV, where we don't have regular crews. We don't have a regular setup. We have to take everything down to the gym. We have to take everything to the football field in order to get it to work. So it takes a lot of time and a lot of preparation just to go on the air.
We started coming up with ideas for the basketball graphics right after football season, and we went through a couple changes, and each time we come up with a new template or a new lower third, it takes like a week of work to go into it. And then once you decide that you don't want to use it, it's going to take pictures of the basketball players when they came and do their interviews, and we were able to superimpose their pictures during the game over their stats. We also used their pictures for a starting five graphic that we started using this year with our new graphics machine. Each design is still original, and each design still has to match all the colors of the game and still has to make sense. So it takes a lot of time and effort and a lot of thinking into it. And I spent a lot of hours after school up here and a lot of hours at home getting everything to work together.
A lot of aspects go into it that people don't even think about or see. Before we even hit the computer's editing, we have to go out and physically film shots we can use of the game. And it takes a lot of time because a lot of times the shots don't happen that you want to see on video. From my perspective, the first thing to editing a video for sports is finding a song.
It's time to compete, Davison.
I think the music behind the video is what captures people's attention more than the video itself. Once you find a song you like, then you can take the shots you took from highlights and put them in a certain order to fit the music. And I think that's what makes things flow the best. That's why it's so important to get a lot of video of highlights so you can find the right shots for the right video. When you're making a video for a sporting event, you want it to be exciting, you want it to build emotion and almost add sort of a tension to the game. You want people to be excited about it. So when you're picking a song and you're making video, you want the video to kind of increase in tension and drama as the music proceeds. The open video is the first thing the audience sees, and it's going to set the tone for the entire production. If you have a boring, open, boring video, people are going to start out with a negative attitude right away. They're going to say, oh, this is boring. Not, oh, wow, this is really exciting. I'm going to watch the whole game.
Ain't no way they can stop me now, daddy, cause I'm on my way. I can feel my ring coming. It's the blood of a champion.
To make a video, you can count in probably three or four games of shooting highlight video, so that's about 2 hours a game. You can count about 2 and 3 hours into planning the video, how you want it to go, the song you want, getting the song onto the CD. And then once everything's on the computer, you're talking a minimum of 3 to 4 hours of editing.
On game day, that's when most of the action happens around here. That's when you see everybody scurrying around to get set up and make everything happen. And you know, most games take two and a half hours. Well, our day is about 5 or 6 hours.
When we set up for an event, we usually arrive 2 hours before the event or 2.5 hours before the event to gather all the cameras, all the cables, all the microphones, all the audio cables, and then we take it to the location, and a lot of time is spent setting it up and making sure that everything works. And in cases of concerts where the video feeds aren't that good back to the control room, we often spend like 20 or 30 minutes actually figuring out which ones work better or making minor adjustments in the audio and video feeds back to the control room. And then after the event, we spend 30 to 45 minutes tearing everything down and putting it back away.
On TV, when you watch it at home, you hear the announcers and you see the sideline reporter, but those aren't the only people that do things. They put in just as much work, but we also have the camera people, and we have the floor director who tells everybody what's going on, and then back in the control room, we've got people on audio, people on tapes for replay. We've got directors, and all these people are just putting in so much hard work, and there's a lot of people that go into it.
Exchange.